Tammy Rubin.
Hi, Sam.
Here we go, friends. You know what? Were you all big ER fans? I certainly was. Obviously, the dominant show. And thus, we press a button all the way to Connecticut. And here comes Anthony Edwards, a film to talk about. We'll do that in just a moment. Anthony, good morning to you.
Good morning, Sam. Good to see you.
Really nice to see you. And I like the headphones. You look very Are you going to spin some tunes for us? You look very DJ-esque.
I know. Your technical director said I had to put headphones on, which I couldn't do it. I couldn't do it songs. So.
There you go.
Okay. All right. Either way, nice to see you. Let me ask you this. Just because of the affiliation with ER, the word that comes to mind is affinity. Do you have a special thought about our first responders and what's happening in emergency rooms nowadays?
I just so wasn't surprised and continue as I was the whole time on ER, impressed with the fact that these people go to work to help people and save lives. And the fact that they're risking and working as a team and doing such heroic work is continues to have just so much respect for, and I'm in awe of.
I tell you what, exactly well said. No question about that. I think your feelings are reflected by many who aren't experienced, you know, never even been to an ER. Let's talk about the tricky part. My sense is, and I don't know this to be the case, did you see this play and then think to yourself, wow, this is something. I've got to help bring this to more people.
Yeah, I mean, it was early on. It was about 6 years ago that I finally faced and looked at the fact that I had been abused and assaulted when I was a kid, and something I'd buried. And when I went into recovery and started working with therapists, I was recommended, hey, you should go check out this play. I went and saw it, and it actually changed my life, because what we have here is a solo performance of a man telling his story of not only the abuse, but really his survival and how he went through it and what it was like as a kid. And this connection that happens when a survivor, someone who has been shut off for so long, hears the story and realizes they're not alone is a really powerful moment to step forward and maybe take initiative to help heal yourself.
So obviously, based on your own experience, seeing the play meant a lot to you. Did you then approach the playwright and the star of the one-man show and say, hey, I want to work with you and do something with this?
Yeah, well, once I came out and started working in the world of helping and supporting men who've dealt with sexual abuse, Marty and I actually became friends. And Marty's an actor in New York, Obie Award winner, Broadway actor. And last year he was doing the show again, just for a limited run. And I thought, we have to capture this. We have to capture this performance, because at 1in6.org, we could use this as a tool to open a conversation, to show to survivors or groups or whatever. And so Raphael Sabarge and I came together, and he shot the film and made it a film. He really captured it in a beautiful way with multiple cameras. And we have this film version of the play. And we were going to take it out to film festivals this year and sell it that way. And as, you know, this virus has put everybody into a different mode, we realized, wow, we have the opportunity to actually stream this live and do it with 1in6 and add the component where we can have a talk back afterwards so that we can screen this film for free on April 30th. And then open up the website and the ability for people who either survivors or families of survivors can go and get help. So it's amazing how it's all kind of come together naturally, and we're really excited about it.
Well, I tell you what, you're going to get a lot of people involved with this. Let's show folks watching right now a look at the tricky part.
His bangs to the right. The gesture, exactly as I remember it, sends this tremble through my chest. It's like I'm 42 and 12 at once. And the person you revile, or the person you hold as the one who damaged you or ruined you, how tricky is it to glimpse divinity even in them? Imagine what our friendship might have been if what, he asked? If you hadn't.
Gosh, that looks really good, Anthony.
Very it's
good.
Really compelling.
Thank you for speaking with us this morning, too. Okay,
it's my
absolutely.
Pleasure,
the tricky
and,
part.
I'm sorry, this is horrible overlap. You're trying to wrap
up. Go on.
And I'm trying to still push.
No,
but, yeah, I just
but
hope everybody...
You conclude with your thought.
Okay, I was just going to say, we really look forward to everybody coming together on April 30th. It'll be live East Coast and West Coast at 8 o'clock p.m., so it should be a good time to sit down and really enjoy this spectacular performance that Marty Moran shares.
All right, Anthony, thank you for that, and I'm going to repeat literally what you just said. The tricky part will be streamed live, Facebook, YouTube, Vimeo, all the home streaming services, April 30th, 8 p.m., head to one, IN6, oneinsix.org, for more information on how you can watch it. Good to see Anthony Edwards there. Friends, we'll go back to you guys in Hollywood.